Hello. Hi guys. Welcome and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, please subscribe. Click on the notification bell to be notified every time I upload a new video. And don't be afraid to leave comments. Kindly let us interact in the comment section. Share this video with others, like, and I hope you learn something from my content. Shira's Painting and Art has been majorly doing content on paintings and art, but I thought, why not explore my other passions? So from today, I'll be bringing you content to do with learning trainings, and I hope that it will be of use to you, and you can share it with whoever you feel it can benefit. So, without further ado, let me introduce my today's topic, which is kinda the reason I chose it is because I wanted to get feedback from you, actually. How do you feel about me changing my content? How do you feel about me venturing into learning, training and learning? And give me feedback. So, my content for today is a topic that I would think I would wish for us to be able to explore together. And let me know on the comment section what you think and how we can venture further into this. So today's content is on mastering the art of giving and receiving feedback. And please do start to engage my comment section and tell me of a time when you had to give feedback, or a time when you were given feedback, whether negative or positive. How was it? How was your experience? And what are some of the things that you encountered, or what was your learning point? What did you learn from that? What was your takeaway? And engage me in the comment section. Please don't forget to like this video, share it with others, and I believe it's going to be of benefit to many of us. And also, please comment from which country you're watching this video from. Let's engage. Let's see how far or how wide our audience is. So, feedback is a crucial component of our personal and professional development. And today we will be exploring the strategies for delivering effective feedback and receiving it constructively. So, comment. Engage that comment section and let us know what are your expectations. What do you expect to learn from this training? And of course, I'm your presenter. My name is Edith, and you can also call me Shira, as my YouTube channel is called. So, allow me to delve into the objectives of this training. What do I expect? You will be able to learn, or what do I expect to help you accomplish by the end of this training? And of course, I hope that by the end of this training, you'll be able to know why feedback matters. Why is it important? Why is feedback important to us? How does it matter? Remember, we said it's a crucial component of our personal and professional growth. So, how is it important? We're also going to be looking at the types of feedback. We have different various types of feedback that are given, and we'll be looking at it or at them. We'll be looking at the feedback giving, or how do we give feedback? Have you ever been a person giving feedback? How did you handle that? How did you manage to give that feedback? Comment on the comment section and let us know. Also, feedback delivery techniques. When you are giving that feedback, or when you are receiving that feedback, what are some of the techniques that you observed, or some of the techniques that you use to give that feedback? Please let us know and engage a discussion in the comment section. Receiving feedback. We're also going to be looking at how you're supposed to receive feedback when you're giving. How do you expect the person you're giving feedback to receive it? And finally, you're going to be looking at overcoming feedback challenges. What are some of the challenges that you have encountered when you're giving feedback? How did you overcome them? What are some of the challenges that you encountered when you are being given feedback? How did you overcome them? These are some of the things that we will be looking at. And if you feel there's something that people need to know, please put it on the comment section. And I hope it will be beneficial to all of us. So we said feedback matters. Let's look at why feedback matters. Why do you think feedback matters? You as an individual, why do you think it's important to receive feedback or to give feedback? Put that on the comment section. One of the things that make feedback matter to us is because it promotes self-awareness and improvement. Being given feedback will help you to become self-aware and to improve yourself. So if something is pointed out to you, it will help you to work towards overcoming maybe your shortcoming, or maybe improving yourself on what you are not doing to us to the par. And also maybe it will help you to just venture into something. If you are being told that you're good at communications, you are good in time management, you want to focus on improving on the other things that you're not so good at. So it helps to promote self-aware. It helps you to understand yourself and your skills and what you're good at. It also helps to strengthen relationships. I mean, if your supervisor, if your colleague gives you feedback every other time, and you are receptive towards that feedback, whether negative or positive, it will help you to have a good relationship with that person who's giving you feedback. It will help you to continue learning. So it seeks to help us improve ourselves day in, day out. Feedback is also effective. When you receive effective feedback, you enhance your productivity and performance. I mean, when you're told that you're good at communication, in communication, what do? You work towards being more productive. I mean, when you receive positive performance review, how do you feel? Feel good. And you mean, you want to receive the same next time. You want to receive good feedback. So you work towards enhancing your performance and productivity. So let's look at types of feedback. What are the different types of feedback that you know? Please put them on the comment section and let us discuss them. From what I have here, I have three types of feedback and allow us to look at the positive feedback. Positive feedback, what do you think positive feedback is? I wish it was a live audience. I would have loved to hear you and respond to this, but you can put that in the comment section. Positive feedback, it helps acknowledge the strengths and the accomplishments to reinforce desired behavior. So when you're given positive feedback or when you're giving positive feedback, you want to acknowledge the strengths that this person have. You want to acknowledge their accomplishments they have made. And this is all geared towards reinforcing a desired behavior. So for example, you have noted someone is very good in communication. So you want to acknowledge that. You want to tell them that they have very good written or verbal communication, and it has seen in a report they submitted, and tell them to keep up. That is positive feedback. When you're giving constructive feedback, which is our second point, it focuses on specific behaviors and offers suggestions for improvement. So for example, you have noted that maybe in my email communications, I tend to send emails to clients and these emails have grammatical errors. So the specific behavior is emails with grammatical errors. So you offer suggestions for improvement. You tell me, Edith, you have been sending emails that have grammatical errors, and it's making our company look bad or our organization look bad. So we want to, I want to help you improve. And the tip that I can offer you is before you send that email, before you click on send in the email, on the email, please invite your colleagues. Invite me as your colleague to come and proofread the email, because sometimes we tend to oversee our own errors when we QC our work. But when we have a third eye looking into what you have been doing, it's going to help them to like pinpoint that error that you have made or you might have made and missed. So I have pinpointed the specific behavior, which is sending emails with grammatical errors. And I've also offered suggestions for improvement. I've told you for you to improve, in order for you to improve, please be asking us to QC your work. And the last or the final, I don't want to call it the final, but the last point is corrective feedback. Corrective feedback focuses or addresses areas needing improvement in a supportive manner. So I'm not gonna like focus on that. I'm gonna look at maybe it's you're coming to work late. So I'm going to address that. I will tell you, you have been getting late to work every single day, and you need to improve. What can I do as your supervisor to help you get to work earlier? Do you need me to create a schedule? Do you need me to change your shifts? What can we do? I'm willing to support you. So that is corrective feedback. If you have any question, don't forget to put it down on the comment section. And let's go on. Let's move on to the next point or the next agenda or the next objective. And this is giving feedback. So we have talked about in the previous slide, we have talked about types of feedback. Now that you have these three types of feedback, how do you give them? How do you give this feedback to the people you are supposed to give feedback to? So number one, you need to be specific. Please comment on the comment section. Let me know, was there a time that you were given feedback that was not specific? So, in order to give specific feedback, you need to describe the observed behavior or the action using concrete examples. For example, I said on the matters communication via email, you point out you have not been communicating. You have been making grammatical errors in your emails to clients. That is a very specific emails to clients and errors. The other thing that you need to do when giving feedback is to ensure that you are timely. Provide feedback promptly, preferably as soon as after the observed behavior. So if, for example, you noted today that I sent the email I sent in the morning was having or had grammatical errors, please make sure that you give me that feedback today so that I'm able to correct that mistake. Don't say I'm gonna talk to Edith next week, because maybe within the course of the remaining days, maybe it's on Tuesday, and I will be sending another email tomorrow and another email the other day and the next day. So by the time you're coming to talk to me, I've made the same mistake five times. So it's important that you provide that feedback promptly and preferably as soon as after the observed behavior. If it's a good thing, it doesn't have to be the negative things. If it's a good thing, tell me, hey, today you did a very nice presentation. Congratulations, that was work well done. It will help me to put more effort in creating the other presentations, the other trainings, the other tasks. So yeah, be timely. The other one is be balanced. What do you mean by be balanced? When we say be balanced, we mean that you offer a mix of positive reinforcements and constructive criticism. So, for example, you don't just have to come and tell me, Edith, you're sending your emails have grammatical errors. What are you doing? How are you presenting us to that? You can tell me, hey, I have noted that you have held down the fort with our mailbox. But I have noted that there are some few grammatical errors. So you have, there's a positive reinforcement. You have commended my job in responding to clients. But then you have brought out the issue that have been making some errors that need to be checked. So be balanced. The other point is be respectful. What do we mean by be respectful? We mean that you need to use a very supportive tone. So be mindful of the tone you use. Let the tone not be a tone to diminish someone, to insult someone, to humiliate someone. Just be respectful and supportive. Focus on the behavior, not the person. When we say focus on the behavior, you're focusing on that email that I've been sending with errors. You're not focusing on me. You're not telling me, I don't know how you look, you are weak, you are stupid. You're not telling me that. You're focusing on the behavior, which is sending grammatically incorrect emails to clients. Be solution oriented. Like I said, when you come to me, suggest actionable steps for improvement. Tell me, I have noted that you struggle with communication. You struggle with giving feedback. Maybe I can help you work on your communication skills. That way, you are pointing out or the thing that I need to work on, but you're also giving me feedback on what or a solution on how to handle my shortcomings. The next topic is on feedback delivery techniques. I asked you when we started, we began this video, I asked you to put down on the comment section some of the feedback delivery techniques that you have used before, which worked for you, which didn't work for you. What are some of these techniques that you can suggest for people reading the comments? And one of the approach or the techniques that we have is the sandwich approach. Who can tell us what sandwich approach is in layman term? So when we say that you use the sandwich approach, we mean you start with a positive feedback, then provide constructive criticism, and end with positive reinforcement. So you have told me, Edith, I have noted that you have been holding down the fort with our emails. So thank you for that. But when I was noting this, I noted that some of the emails that you send out to our clients have grammatical errors. That is you pointing out the criticism. You are criticizing my email sending. You have commended me for a good job in responding to emails, but you have also criticized the kind of responses I'm sending out. And then you tell me, Edith, can I support you in QCing or proofreading the emails before you send them? You have helped me to see a solution to a problem that has been happening. The other technique is called the SBI model, or the situation behavior impact. This, like the word itself, is you describe the situation, the observed behavior, and the impact on performance. So you tell me, for example, Edith, you were late today. And I have noted that this has been very common for you, especially on Mondays. And this is impacting our Monday morning meetings. So you have pointed out the situation. You have talked about the behavior that you have observed and how it has impacted our work. The maybe I am the secretary for this, I'm supposed to be the to be taking notes for these meetings. And if I'm late, it is impacting the meetings from happening. Then we have the, we call it the pendulum technique. This is a technique you use when you're giving feedback or when you're delivering feedback. It means that you alternate between positive and constructive feedback to maintain balance. So you are, it's like you are giving me feedback and at the same time you are, you see how the doctors do. They want to put medicine, like the one that is very strong on your wound, but at the same time, they when they are treating kids, the pediatricians, they sweet talk the child, they tell them sweet things, they even put on music, but they want to inject that person. So you are not sugarcoating, but you are making it, you're packaging it really well to ensure that you're taking into consideration my emotions. So if you have a question, please put it in the comment section. Let's look at the next part, which is receiving feedback. So now you have known how to deliver feedback. You have the techniques, but it's you who is being given the feedback right now. Like this video, guys, like the video, share it with your colleagues, comment, and let's engage in the comment section. So the first thing that you need to do, give me feedback, by the way, give me feedback. I'm waiting for that feedback. The first thing that you need to do is listen actively. One thing about being given feedback, especially when we're talking about constructive criticism or negative feedback, either way, we might rise to be defensive. We might, our first reaction is being like, this person is against me. This person doesn't like me. But I think the best and the most appropriate thing to do at this point is to listen actively. Pay attention to what is being said without interrupting. Don't start defending yourself. Just listen, let them finish. And then you can see what to do next. The other thing that you need to do is the person who is receiving this feedback, you need to stay open-minded. Be receptive. Even if it's very difficult to hear, just listen. Receive this feedback and just know that it's being given to assist you in your tasks. You need to seek clarification. When we say clarification, I say don't just sit down and you really don't know why you're being given this feedback, but you're just there quiet because we said you listen actively. No, seek clarification. Ask these questions to ensure you understand the feedback clearly. For example, you can ask, what can I do to improve? How are you willing to help me to improve? What can I do better? So ask this, seek clarification so that you know how to meet the other person or the person who's giving you the feedback halfway. You also need to express appreciation. Thank you for your feedback. Thank you for noting that I have been sending emails with grammatical errors. Thank you for actually having a good eye to catch that. I appreciate you bringing this to me. And then reflect and act. If this person has told you that I'm willing to support you, don't just assume that or just send the emails and say, I have proofread, I have used grammarly, I've used the other thing, I've just ask them. You have reflected and you are now acting on the points they noted out to you. Let me know what you have been doing. Let me know what you have been doing when you are given feedback. Are you the one who is aggressive, passive aggressive? Are you defensive? Or do you calmly receive the feedback that you have been given? Let us know. Please comment on the comment section and let us know. Let's have this discussion. So let's look at overcoming feedback challenges. What do you do to overcome feedback challenges? What are some of the challenges that come up? And we have defensiveness. How do you overcome defensiveness? You need to avoid becoming defensive. Instead of being defensive, instead of saying, that is how I've always done this. In my previous job, we did this. Instead of becoming defensive, seek to understand the feedback and learn from it. Maybe what you did in your previous job, in your previous task, in your previous employment doesn't work for this new company. So instead of becoming defensive or saying, this is what I was taught in my school, just seek to understand the feedback that has been given and learn from it. Also, you need to embrace criticism. Sometimes you have a problem embracing criticism. We need to view feedback as an opportunity for growth rather than a personal attack. Don't feel like the person who's giving you feedback is attacking you. Take this as a growth opportunity. They are not attacking you. They are trying to help you to grow and improve. We said this course is specifically for personal and professional development. So embrace the criticism that is given to you. One of the other challenge that we have is managing emotions. I'm telling you, people have cried. People have different ways of showing emotions. Some become aggressive, some become like passive aggressive. Like, we have different ways of reacting to things. So one way that you can overcome your emotions and be able to be receptive to feedback is practice emotional intelligence. This will regulate your reactions and responses. It will help you to respond constructively. The next thing that you need to do is seek support. Reach out to your teammates, reach out to your friends, reach out to the person who was giving you feedback. Reach out, reach out, reach out, reach out, and just have a mentor, reach out to colleagues, and seek guidance. If you are not able to process, reach out to someone you trust, maybe a colleague and a mentor. Tell them, help me to process this feedback that was given to me. What do I need to do? What are some of the ways that I can use, or some of the things that I can do to assist me in applying this feedback to make it work for us? Please don't forget to note down on the comment section what we need to do. Then let's look at feedback in the workplace. When we're talking about feedback in the workplace, we are talking about, sorry for that. We are talking about, this is somewhere where we receive a lot of feedback, whether positive or constructive criticism. And one of the things that you need to know is, as an employee, as a supervisor, as a manager, we need to all work together to establish a feedback culture. Let's make it a norm to give and to receive feedback. That way, nobody will feel like they are being attacked when they are being given a feedback. So encourage regular feedback exchanges among team members and managers. Let it be known that feedback is not only for junior employees, it's also for managers, it's also for supervisors, so that nobody will feel like they are being attacked. Let's also normalize performance reviews. Let's use these reviews as a way to give feedback and to recognize achievements by others, address the concerns, and also set goals for development. You know, setting goals will help in giving feedback. For example, when you have set certain goals, you expect that someone is going to give feedback on how you have done to achieve these goals, what you have done, and how you have managed to accomplish what you have managed to accomplish. So let's normalize performance reviews in the workplace. Let's normalize this feedback, like make it normal. You can have quarterly reviews, you can have annual reviews that will help you to work on the feedback that have been provided and work on your goals and to develop personally and also professionally. Then let's normalize peer feedback. Let's foster a culture of peer-to-peer feedback. As an equal in within the workplace, I can let's know that I can give you feedback, you can give me feedback, you can tell me as a team member or a project team member, tell me the way you have done that is gonna keep us doing this for long. So let me show you an easier way, or let's look or put our heads together and come up with a way that we can accomplish this project in time. We as the team for that project. Let's also, what are our key takeaways for this training session? What do we take away from this? Number one, feedback is a valuable tool for personal and professional development. You need feedback. Otherwise, you're going to continue doing things the way you have always done them because nobody is telling you that things have changed. But feedback will create an opportunity for people to reach to you and tell you, you know, we now have online tools to make our presentations look beautiful. You don't have to do it the way it was done in 2004. So you will be able, if you embrace this feedback, you'll be able to learn new skills. For example, video editing, you'll be able to learn use of Excel, you will be able to learn a new skill and develop yourself personally and professionally. Also, when you're given positive feedback, I mean, it motivates you. It does some good things to your self-esteem. So let's normalize feedback and know it's very valuable. Can you master the art of giving and receiving feedback? You are creating a culture of growth, learning, and excellence. Sorry about that. This comes to marks the end of our presentation. I want to thank you for joining this presentation on mastering the art of giving and receiving feedback. And let's all continue to strive for continuous improvement and successes. I want to put this out there. Please comment there the next topic that you want to be you want to see us discussing this. And don't forget to share this video with others. Don't keep this knowledge to yourself. Give me feedback on my presentation, what I can improve and what I can do better. So if you have any questions, please, please, please share them on the comment section. And don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel for more of these upcoming courses. It's your girl, Shira's Painting and Art. Edit, and till next time, bye. It's a wrap. Enjoy your evening, enjoy your day, enjoy your night from wherever you're watching from. Till next time, bye bye.